What's up? So, today is a good day. I've got a whole sunny day, beautiful sunny day, to paint my deck, and that's just what I'm gonna do today. I've been priming. I've already primed a little bit of the front deck, the fore deck, the forward deck. I don't know. So I've already primed it with this Total Boat primer, white. I'll get to work painting with this Total Boat wet edge. I'm so bad.
That's good there.
If you gave me a soapbox, I could talk for hours.
Oh, God. Okay, so I just put on the second coat of paint, and they got this guy over here. I'm gonna show you through the window so it's not creepy. Got a guy on a tractor straightening out the gravel in the marina. In other words, the paint is looking really good. It's not the best environment to be painting, I'm gonna be honest, but it looks really white and good. And I'm really pissed about that tractor guy. No! Alright, well, I'm just having a bit of lunch in my uncle's boat. My uncle's boat is right across the way from my boat, and the tractor just went by my boat. So, if anything, it'll just give it a little character on the starboard side. So, whatever.
See that?
That's peanut butter and jelly, all mixed together. I try to keep things simple in my life. Hey, what's up? Right now, you guys remember the piece of trimming I broke? I'm trying to redeem that situation right now and build some new trimmings. So I'm here with my pawpaw, and he had a big piece of board here, and we believe it's teak. We cut out some pieces of it using the table saw, and we are now going to trace the old piece of trimming onto the new one and cut it out and see how it goes. And this is what we're left with. If you can see for a moment here, I cut them a little bit big. They don't need to be perfect, they're just pieces to trim. So I'm not really gonna like spend too much time on this or anything, but it'll be good to start getting them sanded down and then varnished, and hopefully they look similar. We are actually not 100% certain this is teak, but my pawpaw thinks it is teak, so it was a piece he had laying around that he said he got from a pool company. I hope it's teak. It's got a nice grain to it, but it's very lightweight. It's a very light wood, so I think that's teak. I really don't know anything about wood.
So I want to mention, I was showing my pawpaw my handrail that I have finished varnishing and redoing so that we could kind of do a color match. Doesn't that look so good? All I did was 5 coats of Epiphanes varnish, and I think the last coat came on really nice. It's not the most perfect job, but I think it's pretty good. Cool.
I would just like to say thank you so much to my pawpaw, who is helping me out with this and potentially had the fix to my problem. And I would also like to say that, just to let you guys know, my pawpaw has the coolest barn ever. It literally is the coolest barn slash workshop I've ever seen. And I can't really film and hold all this wood. It's not that easy. Hey guys, like my hat?
Yeah, me too.
But I also want to explain that I'm not really showing every step of the way, nor am I showing how I'm varnishing, like the process, because I'm just kind of like, I'm just varnishing. I just looked up some YouTube videos on how to varnish, read some stuff, and I'm just kind of winging it. And I'm not an expert, nor am I someone that is making a channel showing you how to do what I'm doing. I'm just kind of showing the process of all the restoration and work I'm doing on my boat. So yeah, if you want to learn how to varnish, this is not the video or the channel. And I'm not saying that in a mean way. I'm just kind of want to explain that, like, if it seems like I'm not going into enough detail, it's because that's not what I'm about.
I'm getting my dad to hand sand these right now because I just can't be bothered with that kind of peasant work.
It's the first coat of varnish on these little trim pieces I fabricated. I'm pretty happy with it. I think the color is pretty similar to what the old piece looked like. I think once I put on some more coats and thicker coats, it will look really nice.
What's up? All right, everyone. It's another absolutely beautiful day here down at the Cool Change. It's so beautiful. Last night was probably one of the coldest nights I've had. I think it got down to 35 degrees Fahrenheit. So I was pretty cold. I had a lot of blankets. But I prevailed, and that is a good sign for the upcoming winter, that I'm going to be just okay. Sorry for this terrible light. I just thought it'd be a cool idea to, I don't know, push back the hatch.
Get in the light. Is this better? That way you can see my mustache.
Question to the viewers. Do you think that it's dangerous to have this gas tank full of gasoline next to the outboard in this well?
I'd like to have it to where I can run it shut. And I have a little hole here for ventilation that I think I'm going to maybe make a little bigger and put a vent. And then I have a hole here, which I think I'm going to put a hood over.
Yes, that's kind of how the boat was and has been ran. And I've ran it like that a few times, but I really don't want to blow up. So I guess my question to you guys, or anyone that may be really experienced, and I'm not trying to be like overly cautious here, because honestly, I don't really know where I would put it if it wasn't there. But I just, for anyone that like might look at this and be like, yo, that's super not safe. What are you doing? Could you please let me know? But if not, just let me know that I should vent it really well or something like that. Thank you. So with my standing rigging, for anyone that's wondering what I'm going to do about that, I don't know exactly what I'm going to do about it yet, but I have decided that I'm going to make my own chain plates.
Right down here, these are the pad eyes that I need to replace, okay? I need to replace this one, that one, and this is good. This is a chain plate bolted to the outside of my hull. This thing looks fine. A concern was that these turnbuckles were too old. He thinks these are the original turnbuckles, and I kind of agree. Honestly, they're a little bent, but they, other than being super old, they do look okay. So yeah, the plan is I'm going to measure this chain plate here, and I'm going to buy a piece of stainless steel or steel. I need to kind of do some more research into it. But I guess the plan would be to bolt the new piece right here on the outside where the pad eye would be. And then on the inside of the hull, have a backing plate. And then, you know, bolt it in real good and then just do away with this pad eye altogether. That way I don't have to replace the sinking, the part that's sinking into the deck. I won't have to replace this forward shroud here.
forward lower shroud is really loose, and it's almost all the way maxed out tightening. In fact, you can see like this piece of the turnbuckle is really crooked, so I should probably actually look into replacing these big time. If I relocate the chain plate to over here, that I can kind of give myself a little more play to tighten these up temporarily. I'm gonna try to fix the chain plates because that's super important. So the side stays, I guess that's what you'd say, with the actual chain plates are fine, but the lower shrouds on the port and starboard side are 100% going to need to be, I think, replaced, and I'm gonna try to make my own chain plates. But I think what I'm gonna do is once I fix those chain plates, I think I'm just gonna try to tune the rigging myself. I'm gonna try to learn how to tune it, or maybe I won't. Maybe that's a bad idea, let me know. But I'm gonna try to tune it and see if I can't just straighten up that mass. I mean, I'm telling you guys, it looks like, I'm gonna show you right now, it looks like there's a serious kink in it, and I probably should replace the mass. It's just kind of like crooked, like it's, and I don't know, maybe that's okay. But for now, I think it's fine. It's gonna be something that I'm not gonna let get me down. I'm just gonna fix the chain plates. That'll be a big project, of course. If I get to the point where I can afford it, or I get to the point where I realize, yo, I need to definitely replace the mast and the rigging, then I'll do that. But for now, I'm not. Yeah.